you just get involved in your day-to-day activities and you don't actually take a step back and, one, realize how many people are either in a homeless situation or even at the brinks of a homeless situation, and that could be completely out of their control.
In Cobb County, a lot of times we think that poverty is someplace else.
Right in our community here, there's a lot of suffering going on.
Poverty isn't the homeless person on the street. It could be the people that are giving and they're trying their best, but they can't, you know, improve themselves enough at the moment to make enough money to support their family.
After getting separated from my husband, I was going to work every day, having to pull like 16-hour shifts, 2 or 3 days out of the week. One of my patients, they had like a stomach virus, and I ended up getting sick. And that's how I ended up losing my job and just being down for a while. But I didn't want any help. I thought I could do it on my own. I thought that I would be able to make arrangements and keep my house, but we ended up losing the house. So I had an eviction notice and I had to be out like in a week. And I was nervous and scared, and a friend of mine Googled something and ended up finding CFR, and I got the phone number and I called, and they called me in like the next day. And then when I came in, I had an interview and I did some paperwork and showed her my eviction notice, and I got a key to an apartment like the same day, and it just shocked me. I didn't even know it existed.
We started out as an emergency aid organization, and we helped folks in a crisis. And then I came in with the organization in 1984, and we looked at why folks were finding themselves in an emergency. And I think today we would find the very same things. It'd be lack of affordable housing, lack of affordable transportation, lack of affordable child care, or inadequate education or job training to get and keep a job. So in 1984, we started to focus on how could we impact these things so that we could help folks to remain self-sufficient and not need emergency assistance going forward in the future.
They gave us a clean, safe place to stay, and I was still able to go to work and do everything we were normally doing and take the kids to school. And it was just like a lifesaver, because I don't know where we would have went. I took a budgeting class. We took a lot of financing class on how to manage money and save money. I feel like I'm more prepared for life and more prepared for like just taking care of my kids and just having priorities and not just living on the fly.
I definitely don't think it's the typical people aren't willing to work or pull up their own bootstraps. It's just simply they're down on their luck and they need some help. I think taking each client where they are and not doing a cookie cutter program or cookie cutter plan where everybody gets the same thing is our glue, because success for one family looks different to the next.
A lot of times, especially as a single mom, we're so used to doing everything by ourselves that we don't even think to ask for help, because we're just working so hard, trying to keep it all together. And that right there can sometimes be our demise. They didn't shame me for that or try to make me feel like something was wrong with me. They just were there to really help to kind of restart your life.
They serve a client, and hopefully that client never has to come back and see CFR again.
They focus on educating and empowering their clients so that they can eventually stand on their own feet.
It was like this firm support and love from them, where we believe in you, we want you to do well, and this is what you need to do.
Having that personal attention to help them each step of the way and the accountability for success really makes a difference.
Just to see him now, I can feel that he's kind of just like settled in. I love that he has his own room. We can come downstairs and eat in the kitchen. It's just awesome. Who doesn't want that for themselves and for their family?
Children are our future. Helping them has to help the community. If you don't believe that, I'm not sure what you can believe.
the largest population of homelessness is children. Being on the board allows me to also support those children.
You know, if you can't change both generations, you're really not going to change the whole issue of poverty. So if we can help parents be better role models for their children, then you change the whole life for that next generation.
The constituents that CFR services, or I would say our clients, remind me of myself growing up in the inner city of Atlanta. I grew up in a single parent home. And my mother a lot of times didn't have the financial resources to provide food for me. She actually lost her job and we were homeless for a period of time. I wanted just to find a way to help people that had a similar background as mine.
I grew up in a single parent home. I grew up poor. I get it. I understand that. Today, a two parent family is unusual, and it's important that those people can feel good about themselves and they can have self-esteem.
We lost my grandmother, and she was kind of the foundation to keep us together, and she helped a lot. And when she died, circumstances changed, and school didn't help me bring money home and help with the groceries. And
most people think that you grow up in poverty because you made bad decisions. What I learned, sometimes you just don't have opportunities. It's really the opportunity that's the fundamental variable that determines whether or not you're going to be successful.
WellStar, where I work at now, they turned me down. And it really hurt me. It really broke my spirit down because I was tired of, you know, getting minimum wage and trying to see if I need to pay for the car. Do I pay for my rent? One of them got to go, and you can't go without. And I knew WellStar was going to change that if I got it, but I couldn't get it because I didn't have my GED.
Some people just need bridge help, as I call it, where there are good people sometimes just fall on hard times, as I say, but just need a little help to keep motivated to know that there's a brighter future.
I walked in one day and met Miss Gail. She was just very sweet to me, and I never stopped coming. She just knew it was something bigger for me, and I believed it a lot more when she said it, and we worked together, and I got my GED. I still smile about it. It's nice and crisp. It's pretty still, you know. I take pride in that. Well, I got my job at WellStar. I got a second chance with that. I was able to get my phlebotomy certification, and I'm in college now. I've been trying to do that my whole life.
I definitely know for a fact organizations like CFR do help create productive citizens who do give back to society.
We're putting rent monies back into the community. We're helping families get connected to GED or education to help them get a better job. You know, we're helping families get connected to employment, which then people are paying taxes. So I think our model most definitely impacts this economy. And so if we're able to touch one family or two families or three families, we're all better off for it.
CFR worked with me. They totally make sure that you have what you need to rebuild your life. The computer lab, the job search, you know, I did get rehabilitated for, you know, my issues I had with addiction, and I do have 4 years clean. CFR was able to provide me with my independence and my foundation to become the woman I am today.
Those people that have come through the program are able to stand on their own and be able to then reach back and help someone else.
If we have a lot of families that are struggling, it makes us weaker. If we have families that are independent, strong, working, healthy, and growing, it makes our community stronger.
After graduate school, there was not enough job opportunities within my field. I came here and I applied because I knew I only had about $800, you know, to my name. The day that I put my last $300 down for the next week at a hotel where I was living, they called me. When I moved into the apartment, it wasn't like they just handed me some keys. They gave me comforters, brooms, dustpan, mop, pots, pans. I mean, they really helped me to, you know, get started. And I actually still have some of those things. I think one of the biggest things was here was not only did you have an actual case manager, but they had the employment case manager. She took her time and actually showed me the best ways to really nail a job interview.
I think that was the main thing with me. I had education, I had the will, I had the ambition, but I could not find work. I just needed people to not judge me for a few moments and help me. And I couldn't get that from my family. I couldn't get that from people that I considered to be my friends. But the CFR was the one place where I found it.
One person helping another person is something that should never go out of style.
In the industry of nonprofits, a lot of times it's difficult to measure success and continue to have a good reputation of consistency. And as an outsider, when I first met CFR, I saw both those things.
I would say that the Center for Family Resources changes lives. They provide the assistance to empower people to do what they want with their life, with their family, and with their children.